In the Omnibus Budget Reconciliation Act of 1993, Congress authorized the creation of special needs trusts for the care of individuals with disabilities. Irene Riddell concerns a father's attempt to get his parents' trusts changed to a special needs trust for the care of his disabled daughter. George and Irene Riddell created trusts for the benefit of their grandchildren, Donald and Nancy. Their son, Ralph, was made trustee. These trusts provided that after Ralph and his wife died, Donald and Nancy would receive the trust's benefits until the age of 35. The trust would then terminate, and the trustee would distribute the principal to Donald and Nancy. In the fullness of time, George and Irene died, Ralph became trustee, and Donald and Nancy both passed the age of 35. Donald was an attorney, well able to handle his financial affairs. Nancy, however, was diagnosed with schizophrenic affective disorder and bipolar disorder. She was repeatedly hospitalized for treatment and was unable to live independently. Public financial assistance paid for most of her care. Ralph worried about what would happen when he and his wife died and the trusts terminated. Nancy would receive nearly $700,000. He feared that the funds would either be seized by the state to pay for her large medical bills, or that Nancy would manage them badly due to her mental illness. Ralph petitioned the court to consolidate the trusts and to modify them to create a special needs trust for Nancy. This would make some money unavailable for medical expenses. The trial court found that Ralph wanted to modify the trust to keep the funds out of the hands of the state. Citing the Restatement Third of Trusts, it held that a trust couldn't be modified just to provide an advantage to the beneficiaries. To justify modifying the trust, some unanticipated event that would defeat the trust's purpose had to have occurred. The court found that this trust's purpose was to provide for the education, support, and medical care of the beneficiaries, and this purpose would still be accomplished without modifying the trust. The trial court granted the motion to consolidate the trusts, but denied the motion to modify. Ralph filed a motion for reconsideration, arguing that George and Irene hadn't anticipated that Nancy would suffer from mental illness with extraordinary medical costs. If they had, they wouldn't have structured the trust to leave her a large sum of money. He claimed that distributing the funds to Nancy would defeat the settlers' intent and the trust's purpose. The court denied this motion. Ralph appealed to the Court of Appeals of Washington.